Much appreciate you making your time and the effort to come here this evening to kick off Adare to Survive for the third year in a row. As a lot of you are aware, Adare to Survive kicked off in 2013. It takes place in the grounds of Clonshire Equestrian Centre, for those of you that don't know. And basically it's a 7.5 kilometre military style obstacle challenge. Our website is very informative with regard to what it is, just for those of you that don't know. I'm glad to see a lot of familiar faces coming back to us again, year on year. 95 FM are here with us. David and the Woodlands are here with us. Of course, our sponsors such as Party Time, Noel's Menswear, Lee Trans, and of course our association with Cleona's Foundation, who are the charity partner that we team up with. It's fantastic to see each and one of ye coming back to us every single year. We'd also like to welcome some new sponsors, of course, Hook and Ladder, that you can see with their very flashy mobile kitchen here this evening. They have come on board with us this year and they're a sponsor, and we're delighted to have them on board, and thank them for thank to Andrew and their chef this evening for coming to display what they do and how well they do it. Gino's Ice Cream are taking the position on our t-shirt, on the front of our t-shirt this year, so we're very pleased to have them. And we look forward to a good relationship with them as well. So just to reflect a little bit on last year. Last year was our second year and we saw incredible growth in the event last year. The first year that the Dare to Survive took place, we had 600 people. Last year, just over 1,300 people took part on the course. So that's quite a considerable growth in the round of the year. And we'd expect to have growth like that again this year. Another very exciting and positive thing is to see people like Claire's Wish and St. John's Ambulance there taking their own initiative to use Adare to Survive as a vehicle to raise money for different charities and for different causes. And it even goes as far as Rouen in County Clare Nearly 80 people from their parish are going to take part in Adare to Survive this year to raise money to replace the roof on their school. So it just goes to show what Adare to Survive can do, and when a parish gets together and take part in it, that they can raise money to that sort of extent as well. It's not just, you know, for charities, it can be for communities and be for clubs. And we'd like to get that message across to everybody that we'd like you to use Adare to Survive as a vehicle like that to raise money.
Glad to see so many faces coming back again and new faces again this year. Just going to talk a bit about the obstacle competition that we started last year. It was actually a great success. We had a huge number of entries, and last year we actually built the winning obstacle. This year again it's the same. We have a lot of entries to get through, and it's in conjunction with DML Architects in Limerick, and with myself and Ray. And the lads in the architect firm, we decided to pick a winner. It was a little bit different this year. Last year we picked out a winner and we built it on the day and it was revealed on the day. This year we have picked a winner and already built it, which is what you can see here behind me. The winner of this year's Build an Obstacle competition is Brian O'Donnell from Limerick. Congratulations. Unfortunately, Brian can't be here with us. We were contacting him during the week. He's actually sunning himself for 2 weeks. He has told us that the name of the competition, of the obstacle, is actually Peg. Don't know where he got it, but it's apt nonetheless. In conjunction with the Cleones Foundation and with the winner of the competition, he very kindly accepted a request from us. Could we incorporate the Cleones Foundation? They have a newly formed purple platoon that are taking part on the day.
Terry from Cleones Foundation, and Gwen, it's great to be here for the third year in a row and a beautiful evening again. This year, I won't delay you too long now, this year we have the purple platoon. Basically what it means is that if you register with Cleones Foundation, you'll see the banner there, purple platoon, €5 will go to Cleones Foundation directly to our charity. And so we're really excited, because hence the purple obstacle, and this is new and novel for us this year, so we're really excited about that. I want to wish the boys the best of luck and thank you again this year for choosing Cleones Foundation. I want to congratulate the Fitzgerald family on their 4 stars. Very well deserved. We have a day like this again. Looking forward to it.
We use different initiatives every year in order to encourage people to take on the challenge, to take on Adare to Survive, to come to Clonshire on the 27th of September this year and to experience one of the better events in West Limerick. It draws a lot of people from around the country. It's good for the businesses. It generates revenue around the town. And it's a very good positive vibe and feel for the area. There's quite a bit of excitement. So this year we have decided to dare people to survive. It's very simple. It's along the concept of the Ice Bucket Challenge and all those other different challenges. But instead of nominating them, we're going to dare them to take on the challenge. When they accept to take on the challenge, they then nominate the next person. So it's very, very simple. We nominate them publicly on Facebook, and we're going to begin that this evening. I have somebody in mind particularly that I'm going to dare very shortly. I think that Aoife has as well, I think Mark has. So we're going to get the ball rolling this evening, and we'd like all of ye from the different associations that you're representing to begin that thread this evening by daring somebody publicly on Facebook or Twitter or both to take on the dare to survive. That's why this DARE, hashtag DARE, is here on the ground. That's what it represents and that's what it's all about. And basically it's just a tool to encourage people to dare to survive for 2015.
I suppose with Limerick being the sporting capital of Ireland, if you look at all the teams that have been successful from Limerick, like our hurlers, the rugby team, Munster Rugby, everybody, like teams are the most essential part of sport. And with Limerick's toughest team, 4 people can go in and compete for Claire's Wish. A team mood involved with your friends and edging people on and encouraging each other. It's fun. It's, you could be, get your family involved. All for a great cause with Claire's Wish Foundation. So all people have to do is just simply organise an event with sponsorship and work. especially with the Dare nominations, that what your company could nominate another company to get involved. So there's a lot of scope there for sponsorship and raising great awareness for Clare's Wish. So Limerick has the best teams, but who will be Limerick's toughest team? That's the question. So we're going to have a great sponsorship prize as well at the end of it. We're going to have, there's going to be a lot of incentives for people to get involved, so now's the chance.
I think it looks fantastic. We're hoping to brand up some other obstacles as well as time goes on. So can we have somebody to try our new obstacle? Yeah. They're going to show us how Peg operates. It's not that simple. She's making it look easy, let me tell you, because I tried it earlier on. Well, it is a challenge.
So, guys, thank you very much for coming out. See you in September.